I'm from Miami, Florida.
And I'm from Dresden, Germany.
We started a new initiative of teaching a graduate level master's course, 1 week at the Technical University of Dresden and 1 week at Purdue University.
I needed people who are able to work internationally on projects. So I only hired people with some background in international communication. And I proposed this international course. We wanted to work together. Purdue was perfect. Purdue is a well-known place for compressors. I know Eckhard Groll, a good friend of mine, and we came up with the idea to start this.
I was super excited to be in Germany and to meet the other students.
The moment you get there, you feel like you're learning just being there, and then you get to go to a very old university that's older than probably our country.
Did you try to learn some German?
I did, but I failed miserably, so whenever I needed to order food, Peter and Johannes would help me.
When we were trying to find like a shop at one point, and we were trying to figure out the trams and everything, I tried to like help in German, and my German's not very good, so it didn't maybe confuse the situation, but it was funny.
We all got along really well, I think, and all the activities we did after, so we did a tour.
Did a tour to bits of plant and to visit the manufacturing site of screw compressors.
In their lab, they had setups for us where we could actually see different phenomena going on in the refrigeration system that we normally don't see. So I think TU Dresden did an excellent job in that regard.
After the first week of instruction, we teamed students up one-on-one, one from each university, to work on a project that they had to do long distance over the summer.
We scheduled for almost like a weekly event that we're gonna talk about our tasks.
WhatsApp and Google Hangout.
Skype.
Google Docs and Dropbox.
Mainly Facebook, sending then the documents to each other when you change something. At this point, the distance is then good because like you just discuss what you want to do and then both work on something and then afterwards you send it to each other and then you discuss it.
Right,
so.
I agree.
Most impressed by how quickly they came together and worked together.
We wanted to foster the international exchange of learning, and so they had to come to grips that students from Germany may learn slightly different than students from Purdue, that they tackle problems slightly different.
It's nice to see that we are kind of working in the same field, have the same challenges, but we sometimes have different approaches to it. So we come from one side and the other side, so we can learn from each other.
This course, it's really taught me more than I expected.
The relationships are really big. That was always one of my favorite parts of like getting to go abroad, is you get to meet people from different cultures and like maintain those friendships. And it was really helpful to build that relationship, both on like a friendship level, but also on a professional level.
As soon as you graduate and you go out in the real world, you realize that all engineering is done on a global basis.
R&D team in Japan, we had the factory in the Czech Republic, we had customers in China.
So it's important for Purdue students to get exposed to how engineers from the other culture are tackling the same problem.
It's really unique that that industry stands up and says, this is something that we are interested in. You can say they are really, all of them are really one team. It's perfect.